This might be the most unexpected, unconventional gear review that you will ever see on YouTube. Alright, it's your camera boy Jonah and I'm super excited about this video. Who wouldn't? Because One DX Mark III, baby, I finally got it. You can watch this gear review even if you're not interested in a One DX Mark III. It will actually apply to all the gear out there. I'm very excited about this video because it's a totally not conventional gear review. Please watch it till the end. You will understand what I mean with it. And it would mean a lot to me because this video is very important to me. First, let's shoot and show you people some footage of our trusted, beloved Mark II. Now the exciting part, let's play with our new toy, the Mark III. Sitting in my throne, trying to get that lady. I'm plugging to the natural. Remind myself of love and life. Could have been just shadow. But it's shallow water on my back. Listening forward to my fantasies. Won't take this world for granted. Find all the answers. Confused so I don't follow. Need for my mind. Loving all the time. Money don't override. Getting papers, paper, getting great ties, great ties. So peace, so sweet, so beautiful. I'm already super excited because on the back of the screen it looked so much more crisp than the Mark II. I'll put them now side by side in the editing so you people can compare for yourself which look you like more. I think both you and me can agree that the One DX III looks amazing, but now it's time for the unconventional part of this review, and a lot of people might hate me for saying this. I don't care, it's really important for me. Sometimes YouTube seems to be a place where there's like such a gear rush going on all the time, so there needs to be some counterweight for balance. So here we go. The chances are pretty high that you've probably already watched another video about this camera. And, well, the chances are high, I would say, that you probably didn't realize that I wasn't showing you the Mark II and the Mark III. I was showing you two times the Mark II. All I did was switch up the settings a little bit to make it a better, more crisp look. But before you dislike this video, guys, please wait. Let me explain why I did this to you. Why am I such a bastard that I showed you two times the Mark II? Actually, thumbs up this video, please. It's pretty cold and I'm still trying to make a video for you that I think will be really useful. I remember watching one of my now favorite YouTubers, shout out James Matthews.
Everyone is so caught up in what equipment they're using, how sharp their lens is, what picture profile they're on, if they've got a drone. People are spending so much time and money on what gear they're using and spending little to no time whatsoever on what is directly in front of them. So there's a lot of videographers around nowadays, and there doesn't seem to be as many directors. To me, a director is more worried about what is in front of the lens rather than what is going on behind it.
Shooting really awesome content that really felt inspiring to me. And you know, as every YouTube video, the comment section is full with what camera do you use, what lens do you use, what gimbal do you use, all kinds of gear related questions. And you know what was the interesting answer of James? James was actually shooting with two of the most cheapest lenses that you can find ever made. One was a 10 to 18 kit lens of Canon, and then the other one was the Nifty 50 Plastic Fantastic 50mm 1.8 from Canon. Both of these lenses are around $100 or $150 or something. And you know what's even crazier? He was shooting them adapted to a Sony body. And I remember him explaining why he was shooting with these lenses. I never forget what he said. And what he said was, you know, all people spend thousands and thousands of dollars on new gear, new lenses, new camera bodies, new gimbals, all that stuff. But the one thing they don't do is invest in where they go and what they shoot. Some of my personal favorite shots I took not that long ago, they're shots from Portugal. And you know what makes these shots amazing? It's not the camera, it's not the type of lens. Yes, they are good, but it doesn't matter. Really, 90% of these shots are made up because of the fact that I woke up for sunrise, I had amazing light, I had an amazing location that was empty because I was there at sunrise, not at sunset. I was there at sunrise, so there were no people, just me and the model, who is my girlfriend, who is now holding this camera. Thumbs up for her holding a 1DX Mark II all this time. She's having a little workout. But now back to the topic. As I said, these shots look amazing because of the location, the light, the timing, there were no people. All these things combined make that they are awesome, not the camera. And then here we all are talking about gear, watching videos about gear, instead of saving some money on the gear expenses and actually going to places that are amazing to capture, locations that are worth capturing with the right model in the right time and the right place, and you get so much better footage than whatever camera you're gonna buy. Thing that actually kind of commercial marketing pushes towards you on YouTube, because in the end of the day, most YouTubers are sponsored by these brands to show you these videos. What actually might really change your life and change that you will finally shoot the content that you want to shoot and not do stupid jobs in a style that you don't want to do. For example, some of you people might want to create travel content. Now, buying a more crazy camera is maybe not the thing that will make you be a travel videographer. What will maybe make you a travel videographer is saving some of that money, actually making a really awesome trip on your own, investing this money in yourself, making a trip instead of investing in a new camera body or camera lens. Go travel and shoot that amazing travel content, because that way you really have to show something to potential clients. Because if you sit in an uninteresting place with a 1DX Mark II, 3, it doesn't matter. The footage will not be interesting and you won't convince clients to hire you. But actually, with a less good camera, going to an amazing travel location, taking your time to shoot in the right light, in the right place, with the right model, will give you so much better footage that you can actually land the jobs that you want later on. Think about it, I know it's scary to do. Investing in gear is kind of a safe investment. You know you can sell it later, you know that your image quality is going to go up for sure. With the other one, you're not really sure what will come back out of it, but I'm pretty sure something much better than just buying a better lens or camera. Let me now also show you some examples that you don't always need the best camera, and that actually having a worse camera might make you way more creative than the other people, and the client will love you better.
Yes.
For example, I was shooting at Tomorrowland, and when I arrived, to be honest, I was kind of sad because most of the people had two 1DX Mark IIs hanging around them, one with a big wide angle lens and one with a 70-200. And I just had a crop sensor camera. I think it was a Canon 70D, or maybe then I upgraded already to the Canon 80D. Either way, it was a crop sensor camera. So I didn't have this nice full frame sensor with a nice wide angle lens to capture those epic crowd shots. But this limit of gear actually made me way more creative. Every day we got a big list of stuff that they wanted to have captured. And one of the things was, for example, flags. Everybody on Tomorrowland has the flag of their country, so they want pictures of these flags. Now, I'm sitting there with my one setup, thinking how can I do something different than the other people, something to stand out, where maybe the quality of the shot isn't the most important, but just because it's something different, it will stand out and they will actually like it. Now I made this series where I actually went up to people who had a flag and I asked them like, hey, let's make a cool shot, a creative shot with you and your flag. For example, I made some shots where I was under the flag together with a person and I took a picture. So the flag was really like a nice leading line towards the person's face. And this happened because I, for example, didn't have a 7200, so I couldn't be shooting people from a distance and capturing them spontaneously. People saw me because I had to get close to them, and actually that's why I like these shots much more. It's a personal shot, and the funny thing is Tomorrowland liked these shots a lot, and a lot of them were posted in the Tomorrowland paper and on the website and all that stuff. So that's actually pretty awesome to be capturing photos that Tomorrowland uses while I'm just there with a crop sensor camera. And these other people have two 1DX Mark IIs. So don't be discouraged, your camera doesn't always matter that much, but more what you do with it and the way that you can creatively think about new shots that haven't been done before and make you stand out. I'll give you another example. I had to shoot some photos at Paris Fashion Week for a newspaper. Now, kind of the same scenario as Tomorrowland. I arrived there with my Canon 70D, I'm sure. Back then I had my first camera, it was a Canon crop sensor camera. Canon 70D, amazing camera to start with. So, anyways, I was there, I look around, and I see everybody having this 1DX with a 70 to 200, so they could be snapping pictures from a distance of the model. And I was there with something like an 18 to 35 1.8, which was nice, I had a 1.8. Hey, that's actually not that bad of a lens, to be honest. But the thing was, it was difficult for me to capture these models when they were coming out. I just didn't have a tight enough shot yet from that space because my lens didn't have a long focal length. But it actually made me end up again with much more nice shots because I had to think about a creative way. And instead of being there together with all these photographers waiting for a model to leave her show and then capturing her from a distance, I stood away 5 meters later and I let the first model pass, and when the older photographers are all together on the new model that was coming out. So I just went up to the model, I politely asked her, hey, can I snap a quick pic of you? And actually I ended up with much more intimate portraits than the other photographers who had this typical 200 millimeter distance type of shots with, you know, less of a feeling of being there together with the model, while I had shots where the model was looking straight at me. It was and portrait actually, and the newspaper was extremely happy with these shots. I also was extremely happy because I found them much more personal and intimate than a lot of the photos that I saw from these other photographers with their 1DX and 70 to 200 millimeter lens. What am I trying to say with this video? Please keep buying all the gear you want. Gear is awesome. I myself too love gear. And there are also really situations where you really need better gear to be able to capture what you want to capture. But just remember to sometimes slow it down and don't go all too crazy about all the stuff you see passing on YouTube all the time. All the new gear, you don't need it. And maybe save up a little money and invest a little bit on shooting projects that you actually really like shooting. For example, maybe you want to start shooting music videos and you haven't ever shot a music video. Maybe just shoot one for free, or even invest a little bit yourself. Go to a studio, rent amazing lights. It will cost you a little bit of money, but then you have a really nice example that you can send to a bunch of artists, and maybe you can finally start making music videos as you wanted already to do for a long time, instead of having a new camera but not actually shooting what you want to shoot. So please click off the gear reviews. It's an amazing time now to learn, to check out some tutorials on how to actually really use the camera that you already have. Use it up till its limits, then buy some new gear. But until then, just try to master your camera that you have right now. Really squeeze it like a lemon. Create what you want to create so you will attract the customers that you want to attract, and then in a later stage, just buy the gear when you really need it. Your camera boy Jonah out. See you in the next one. Bye bye. Got this music popping, now I'm needing stress. Told my mama she don't even gotta stress. Told the God and he told me that I'm blessed. Yeah, they hating cause they know that I ain't.